So excited to be here today. Have you all gone back to school? I can't wait to go back to Power Zone and Grow Zone and Tot Zone and Go Zone and have fun learning about Jesus. But for now, we can just have fun learning about Jesus online. But I'd like to introduce you to Blubber. Blubber's an Egyptian goose. He fell out of the nest in our tree, so I'm just taking care of him for today. How do we know that Blubber's an Egyptian goose? Well, look at his little beak. Look at his little feet and his little tiny wings and his fuzzy little feathers. But mostly we know he's Egyptian goose because we've seen his mom and dad and we've identified them as Egyptian geese. So Blubber must be an Egyptian goose. I got an idea. Let's play a game. Okay. If you have a brother, put up your right hand. If you have a sister, put up your left hand. Do you have a sister? Okay, now if you have a pet, make its noise. So if you have a dog, you're gonna woof, woof, woof. If you have a cat, let's hear, what are you gonna say? That's right. I don't know what hamsters say. But birds go chirp, 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 chirp. Okay. Now, if you wear glasses, nod your head. If you play an instrument, stand on one foot. If you like to read, wriggle your fingers. If you are adopted, give someone a hug. If you like to do sports, wiggle your toes. If you're a dancer, spin around 3 times. If you like to make people laugh, hop around on one foot. That was so much fun. Let's hear from some friends about who they are.
I'm a dad.
I am a musician.
I am a little builder.
I'm a bookkeeper.
I am a sound guy.
I am a swimmer.
I am a teacher.
I am a law student.
I am a mom.
I'm a dirt bike rider.
I am a physiotherapist.
I'm a sister.
I am a grandpa.
Today we're going to be talking about identity. That's kind of a big word, but identity just means who you are. Let me break it down for you. Maybe you're a ballerina, or you're funny, or you're adopted, or you're good at sports. Maybe you're a brother, or a sister, or a gamer, or maybe you wear glasses. Those might all be one part of you, but they're not who you are, because all those little things that are a part of you are just that, one part of you. They don't make you you. God does that. The only real identity you have, the thing that makes you who you are, is this. That you are made by God and you are loved by God. You may feel like you're supposed to be a lot of things, but all you need to know is that God loves you. He's always with you. He has a plan for your life because you're his child. We all are, so we can trust him. Let's see what the Bible has to say about this. In 1 John chapter 3 verse 1 it says, "See what great love the Father has lavished on us, that we should be called children of God." He loves us. In Joshua chapter 1 verse 9, it says, "Be strong and courageous. Do not be frightened. Do not be dismayed. For the Lord your God will be with you wherever you go. He is always with you." in Jeremiah 29 verse 11, it says, I know the plans I have for you, declares the Lord, plans to prosper you and not to harm you, plans to give you a hope and a future. God has plans for us, good plans. In Psalm 9 verse 10, it says, those who know your name trust in you because you have not abandoned those who seek you, Lord. We can trust him because he will never abandon us. Let's see what our friends say about their identity, who they are, now.
I'm a child of God.
I am a child of God.
I'm a child of God.
I am 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 a son of God.
I am a child of God.
And I'm a child of God.
I am a son of God.
I'm a child of God.
I am a child of God.
Our Bible story today is about Ruth and how she got to be part of God's family too.
God's story, Ruth. So part of God's story is about a woman named Ruth, and it begins like this. Ruth lived in a place called Moab and was married to a guy who was part of God's special family, the Israelites. A few years later, though, Ruth's husband died. Instead of returning to her family, which would have been expected, she stayed with Naomi, her husband's mom. Naomi tried to get Ruth to go back to her family in Moab, but Ruth wouldn't leave Naomi, no matter what. In fact, she wanted to go back to Israel with her. Ruth said, "Your people will be my people, and your God will be my God." So they both returned to Naomi's home in Bethlehem. Back then, though, it was hard for women to find work. Usually, they had to be taken care of by their husband or a dad. It's really hard to imagine that now, but Naomi and Ruth might not have even known how they'd survive. At first, to get food, Ruth went to the fields of a man named Boaz and followed his harvesters around. If they dropped anything, even just a piece of grain, she picked it up. This was called gleaning. Ruth worked from morning to night and barely even took a break. Boaz noticed. He told his workers to leave behind some extra grain for her to gather. When Naomi heard about this, she was overjoyed because Boaz was Naomi's relative and what's called a family redeemer. That meant that it was his responsibility to take care of his family. If anybody was going to rescue Ruth and Naomi, it was Boaz. Kids, we have a redeemer too. It's Jesus. He's the one who saves us. Anyway, this gave Naomi an idea. She told Ruth to put on her best clothes and perfume and then go to the place where Boaz was sleeping. Naomi said that once Boaz had gone to sleep, Ruth should lay down by his feet. Now, this may sound like a weird plan, but it was actually really brave. Ruth trusted Naomi and obeyed. When Boaz woke up, he was surprised. After all, someone was lying at his feet. That's not exactly a normal night. When Boaz asked who Ruth was, she said, "I am your servant. You are my family redeemer." Now Boaz understood. Ruth wanted Boaz to marry her so that she and Naomi would both be taken care of. Boaz agreed. This was a huge deal. Ruth wasn't an Israelite, but she wanted to follow God anyway. By marrying Boaz, she got to officially be part of God's family. In fact, Ruth's great-grandson was King David. And many, many years later, Jesus, the rescuer, was born into the same family line. Now, because of Jesus, we get to be a part of God's family too.
Let's pray. Thank you, God, that we are made by you and we are loved by you. In Jesus' name. Amen. Let's worship him together.
subscribe.